Hold up. It's that boy G-Plan. Don't give a damn. He cooler than a fan. Walking real tall, some say he's a man.
I want to say I appreciate you in your face of what you did for the state.
Right, right.
Me and Louisiana Hood DJ, we had a conversation on Instagram Live about it. And I told him that, bro, DJ Chill was the reason a lot of music made it up this way. You know what I'm saying?
The pipeline, because of the mixtapes. DJs would buy my club mixtapes. I would go to Pookie's. You know what I'm saying? Right there, Alexander's Pookie's Fun House. That's when the mom and pop stores was. He still had to go buy them CDs. Mm-hmm. I can go there. Up in Shreveport, Jabba Jaws had a store. Mm-hmm. I used to have my mixtapes in. And how we got that going is me and Bebe been cool since the Bunny Hop. Mm-hmm. When he had the little orange minivan with the champagne bottles and the Dayton's on it. It was before with the gold teeth, not the platinum teeth. Mm-hmm. Me and Bebe, I would go up there. And it's like with the first Cocoa Palace. Me and Bebe were, you know what I'm saying, we were switching. I toured with Hurricane Chris. Mm-hmm. So we would switch, you know what I'm saying? This was before A Bebe. Mm-hmm. Go to Cocoa Palace, you know what I'm saying? On my mixtape run, I go to the club, we swap our music. So I would bring all the Baton Rouge music and stuff from down this way to Bebe, and in return, him and Chico would make me a CD of all the up north stuff. Cause you know, it was like all in water. Even though it was still a jig feel, it was just different. So, you know what I'm saying? I would take, that's when I got the beat. The Shreveport, I call it the Shreveport beat. You know the beat, that beat. Dun, 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 dun. Yep, I brought that down here. I brought who else was hot up there? They Pill movement that was going on. Big Papa, before the pill, what the pill is that? A Wild Yellow. Oh, yeah. I'm feeling myself. Shit, I go back further than that. Hurricane Chris' first song was that Bang.
Bang.
That used Bang. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Bang, bang, bang. Bang, bang. Bang. Yep. That's how I broke Hurricane Chris down here before the A-Van Bay. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that was the pipeline. We call it the pipeline, bro. We get in my truck, I gas my shit up. You know what I'm saying? I get on the highway. I done lost more money, gas wise, just to go pick up money. Mm-hmm. See what I'm saying? I drive 2 hours to go pick up $50 to $75. Mm-hmm. You know, 2 hours away. Mm-hmm. Come right back, turn around, trip. But it was the grind back then, bro.
You really, at the time, was a gatekeeper in the sense as far as music getting here, music coming there, and if Chill ain't breaking it, who breaking it?
At one time, yeah, bro.
It's like, I appreciate the DJs, and before I came up with this list with my people, I was like, man, like in the blog world, you got all type of lists, rapper lists, videographer lists, stuff like that.
Right.
And everything so fast, people don't come and respect the DJ and say, I'm gonna sit here and build a relationship, everything fast.
Uh-huh.
I'm like, I wanna do something for the DJ, especially in the state. And that's how it all happened. Now for the commotion, like I say, it was crazy. But
hey man, and I tell some of these DJs, bro. Especially these young DJs, man. You out here, you been DJing 5, 6 years, 7 years, man. You ain't did nothing yet.
Exactly.
Like, you ain't, you know what I'm saying? Like, if you go to somebody's city and your name ain't the first two names they come out your mouth, you ain't did nothing yet. So you can't be mad if you ain't make the list, you know what I'm saying? Like that. And then once again, like I said, bro, it's a list.
It's a list.
At the end of the day, get your bag.
Yeah.
Get your money.
Now some people was telling me, oh, you don't have enough down south people on there. I say, what are you talking about? Jubilee, Black Amar, Chill,
yep.
Manny Fresh,
yep.
Super Mike,
yep.
Goddamn, who else I got on there? Dobie D,
yep.
Sexy Lex, Chris Major,
right?
We got DJ Sausage. He coming up down there.
Doing upcoming, right.
That's half of the list right there. So I tried to make it halfway. Like, even out, you know what I'm saying? So
yeah, I mean, it's like you said, man, it was like one of the cup cats that should have been on now, but it was an honest mistake.
Yeah,
it happens, you know what I'm saying? And the few cats, like I said, that I talked to, it wasn't even tripping. You know what I'm saying? It'd be everybody else. Man, why you ain't, you know what I'm saying, man? Calm down, man. Calm all that shit down, bro. It ain't that serious.
I wanted to make sure, in my opinion, first, the top 5/10, I wanted to make sure it was almost undeniable. Like I say, we missed Move.
Right.
But everything else, I don't see how you can argue with that.
I mean, it's like I said, you got DJ Hollaback.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I ain't nobody.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like you got Hollaback and you got you know what I'm saying, you got DJ Double S out there in Lake Charles. Oh, you know,
Double S. I knew about Sexy Lex because he got
right. But Charles, yeah, but like I said, right, y'all closer to the same age. So when Lex moved from Lake Charles and came down here, was in Club Rain and stuff, and he was doing his chant. Matter of fact, a lot of them chants, not a lot of them, his main chant come from come from the Shreveport music that I had brought down here. He would hear me play because he would MC then everything I would do. He would MC for me and Dobie. And sometimes all three of us would be in the club and we would play this. He would take it. He would take the chance, use some of that, put it into his own words, and that shit, it became a staple. You know what I'm saying?
That's how you gotta bridge.
That's how you gotta do it, bro.
You gotta do it. Now, I wanna take it here, man. We talked about the list, man. All
right.
One group that I still love to this day, but everybody doing their own thing, was 3D.
Right, right.
At one point, Lil Fat, Shell, and Mouse, they had clubs turned upside down.
Man.
Can you talk about that experience with Mouse, Shell, and Lil Fat? They were amazing, man. You talking about a promoter? Hey, you talking about a packed house?
I'm thinking it's probably one of the top five groups that came out of Louisiana. Real talk. And I'm gonna tell you why. It's because, like you said, it wasn't nowhere you wasn't going to where they wasn't playing some of their music. They kept a rotation of, like, man, let me tell you, I'm gonna just name some of them. You had Do It Stick It. Right, that's on 3, that's Do It Stick It. Then you had Wash My Shoes. Them two songs alone, we toured. We'd be in St. Louis, we'd be in South Carolina. We just off them two songs alone. You see what I'm saying? Then let's talk about the underground shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm All The Way. I'm gonna stop right there. It's just three songs. And let me tell you something. Fat was about 15, 16 when all that was going on.
R.I.P. Lil Fat, man.
R.I.P. to my little brother, Lil Fat, man. You know what I'm saying? All that, he was young. I got records on my computer right now, brother. You hear Fat, you'd be like, man, I can't believe it.
You got unreleased records?
I got a lot of Trill unreleased shit. You know what I'm saying? I got a lot of stuff that I think at the time, but he just didn't push it. You know what I'm saying? Like, a lot of old 3 Deep records. Cause you gotta realize I was Trill Entertainment's DJ, so I would go back home to the studio, you know what I'm saying, at the studio that they had on Dallas down in Baton Rouge, and I would go to the CEO house, the homie Big Mel, the brother Big Mel, you know, I would go to Mel house, and you know what I'm saying, we'd be putting all these mixtapes together. It just wasn't like, okay, these are songs I want. He would give me everything, be like, we gonna pick. Almost like how you pick for an album, because you gotta realize that was some of the first, calling it mixtapes, but it was original songs era. And you know, Fat did his thing, you know what I'm saying? Mouse, you already know about Mouse with the production. He was the dumbest. He's still a sick. You know what I'm saying? And Shell.
Yeah.
Shell probably was one of the most slept on.
He was slept on, dog.
Shell could rap his ass off from New Orleans. Shell still could rap his ass off. And if you go back and listen to a lot of the verses that he do, man, Shell go hard. The cartoon. You remember the cartoon?
That song went crazy.
I'm naming songs. How old these songs is, bro? This
10?
At least 10 years old.
That was 2000. Let me see, I really started coming down here like 2010, 9 and 10.
You talking about
10.
Man, you talking about doing a show to where every song we would do, motherfucker was to the ceiling. Yeah. Every song.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't care if the show was 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 15 minutes, every song we was doing, it was to the ceiling, bro. So